Hello, everybody. Welcome to Stratoscale Hybrid DevOps Pros. I'm Ariel. With me is Liaz.
Ariel.
And today we're going to talk about Symphony DevOps using Hashicorp Packer and Terraform.
Yes.
Fantastic. Take us away, Liaz.
Okay, so one of the biggest problems our customers are tackling is the automation of images. We talk about here a lot about applications and so on, but application need a solid foundation. And usually that solid foundation is the image. You have many applications.
So how to get my application to the platform?
That's the foundation. So everybody thinks they're a snowflake, right? My application everybody's is special.
Different.
Everybody's different. Every team is different. And every team now wants to build its own image. And that becomes when you scale up to hundreds
of applications. It's a challenge to manage that.
It's a huge challenge. So this is why our friends at Hashicorp have done it right. And they're doing tons of stuff with infrastructure as code. So the first thing that they have is they managed to do is everything is working now using Terraform. So I can build my own infrastructure. So that infrastructure will be the solid foundation for my Packer. And Packer, which is also an infrastructure as code tool, it will build the application itself. Actually, it will build the image to run that application.
So when we're using an AWS compatible set of APIs for supporting image management and instance management on the platform, we can actually take advantage of these wonderful DevOps mm-hmm. tools to be able to deploy my entire chain on platform. Fantastic. So let's look at how Symphony does that.
Okay, so that's my UI of Symphony. Again, this is the networking overview.
Okay, we'll so see you a small VPC mm-hmm. with a few things in it.
Right, so that's actually the default VPC. And we're not going to use the default VPC, and for a very good reason. I like to isolate and secure everything. So first, let's run my Terraform, and my Terraform will do that. It will create its own VPC, its own isolated network, security groups, and so on. It will create key pairs, and everything will be safe and secured inside my own isolated network.
So we're creating an isolated environment, mm-hmm. Using Terraform to deploy that.
Exactly.
Fantastic.
I think it's very useful when you're working many people, maybe, or even some CICDs.
I've seen many examples of teams mm-hmm. that are collaborating, but in fact, they're actually interfering with each other because they're stepping on each other's mm-hmm. toes.
Yeah, you need to take also that it's not always humans. You have CICD machines and so on working
so
together.
So being able to create multiple environments, being able to isolate different applications mm-hmm. and different teams on the same platform,
yes.
Using something like Terraform is actually quite easy.
Yes, so we see here that we have our VPC, we have our own Bastion subnet, and a Bastion instance.
Okay.
The Bastion will just be a secure, hardened jump server that will allow us to SSH, to rely Packer to SSH into whatever instance it will create.
Fantastic.
Okay, so
Terraform makes it so easy.
Yes, so what Terraform also did for us, and that's the big thing, it created the Packer template. So Packer needs to know how to jump into his own instance. So everything is set here, and you can see that right now I have a Packer generated JSON right here, and when I will run it, Packer will do that. It will, okay, we can see that it starts running. Okay, so I gave Packer its own parameters. Let's see where I did that. We have our public Strato AWS examples repository.
Okay. You put the Packer example there.
That's right. So I invite everybody to go and take a look at that repository. Don't forget to stars, of course. And you can free to fork and clone it. It's completely public. And here I have all my Terraform and I have my template.
Okay.
So that template will actually create everything that Packer needs, and it will Terraform will put whatever arguments it knows, and it will put it in the template. And this is actually what Packer will do. Packer will start a virtual machine. You can see it starting here. It's called Packer Builder.
Mm-hmm.
The Packer Builder will go inside into Packer Builder, and it will build actually it will update and then install Docker.
Oh.
That's the image I'm
a very simple application.
It's a very simple application.
Okay.
It's very useful. So once Packer Once Packer is done, you can see here, Packer is already running and installing everything that asks it to install inside, and it's working now inside this Packer builder. I'm just using shell. You can go into HashiCorp documentation. Packer has endless options of provisioners. You can do things that are post-provision, very easy to automate using CI/CD. As you see here, using Symphony, you don't need to know a lot about coding on Packer. You just clone that, go back here, you put everything into the TFRs, very easy to understand. Everything is well documented inside Symphony.
Okay, and you can just start building images.
That's right. And then Packer builds the image, creates the AMI, as you can see here, put that back into Symphony. Let's go to images. There it is, Packer example. This is your AMI already in AWS API standards of AMI. You can put that into another Terraform that runs over Symphony, and you can create your own application, and you can scale.
So easy.
Very easy.
Great. So we've just seen how we can automate an application build using HashiCorp's Packer and Terraform running on Symphony with AWS APIs. Thanks,
Jess. Take care of you.